Well, there have been several incidents, two really serious ones that stick in the mind. First one was in 1982 when the volcano Mount Gulungong went off, and there was the British Airways flight that was flying at 36,000 feet and all the engines stopped. And the pilots had a nightmare of a time, but they got down to about 11,000 feet and they managed to restart the engines. The second case was about 7 years later over Mount Redoubt in Alaska. In that case, they were at about 40,000 feet. All four engines stopped, and eventually they managed to restart and make a safe landing. Before the Gulungong incident, we all thought it was, you just get a bit of wear on these blades because it's sandy and abrasive, and you might block up some holes in the turbines. That, of course, is a long-term deterioration. It doesn't stop the engines. The thing that stops the engines, and there was a very long and careful investigation, well, after both the events, but there was a huge report in the US Geological Survey, which is interesting that it's the geologists getting involved as well as the engineers, which shows that the contents of these volcanic clouds contain a lot of particles which are rather like glass. And what happens is that these particles, they enter the engine and they get to the combustion chamber here, which is like a furnace, well over 1,000 degrees centigrade. The particles get into the combustor and then this liquid glass, which is a sort of thick syrupy liquid, sprays over the turbines. And it partially blocks the air passages so that the right amount of air can't get through the engine anymore. That's the fan, which sucks air in. That's the compressor, which compresses it. Then the fuel is squirted into the combustor, which of course gets very hot. And then the hot gases expand out to the turbines. And the turbines are there to drive the compressor. And it's the nozzle guide vanes here and the turbine blades that follow that are covered in the glass. I mean, the damage to the compressors is quite serious, but it isn't that which shut the engine down. Yes, I went to a talk by the pilots of the Gulungong event, who told a very moving and dramatic story. But the first thing they saw was sort of sparks and a glow of light in front of the windscreen. And the passengers could see flashes of light from the wing leading edges and streaks of flame or orange light coming out of both the back and the front of the engines, which was all these particles glowing. The effect was to sort of sandblast the windscreen so they couldn't see through it anymore. When they came into land, they had great difficulty, and one of the pilots was standing up and talking to the other pilot, and there was just a tiny, clear bit of glass right at the edge of the windscreen. And they came in basically on instruments, but for the last bit, you do need to see where you're going.
Some people might think they're being overly cautious by grounding all these planes. What do you think about that?
The Gulungong passengers formed an association and have formed a club. And having been on an aeroplane for, I think it was something more than 11 minutes without power, and writing notes to your nearest and dearest and thinking your end had come. Now, at least two plane loads of passengers have had that experience. And I don't think anybody else would like the experience. The aero engine manufacturers do all they can to cope with the effects of dust, but there's no way you can cope with coating your turbine in glass. It's just, all you can do is just avoid it, and all the effort since has been keep out of the clouds.